Members of Parliament on the Health Committee are demanding that clothing and other non-meat vendors vacate the city abattoir premises to ensure good meat quality. This was after they inspected hygiene and sanitation of the facility. Members of Parliament on the Health Committee, led by Chairperson Dr. Joseph Ruyonga, today visited the Kampala City Abattoir at Portable Road to assess hygiene and sanitation. The legislators were disturbed by the congestion and the mix-up of activities they found within the facility designated for a slaughterhouse.
The reason we are here is because we're having so many challenges in markets and the abattoir in the most recent years. And that was because of the management problems that were happening, coming from the associations, the interim leaders, and all of those other challenges.
The traders, led by Chairman John Bosco Kidu, attributed the situation to Basaja Balaba's tenure when market vendors were first allowed in. However, MPs emphasized that the abattoir should focus exclusively on slaughtering and meat trade to ensure good meat quality. Dr. Musunga David, KCCA Deputy Head of Production Marketing, cited the ongoing dispute between the government and Basaja Balaba as a hindrance to improvements.
For all these other businesses, ideally, are not supposed to be here. We have been informed the genesis of it, that this was originally an abattoir, but later on, the private entity that was given to manage it turned it into a market. So now KCCA needs to come up with a plan to convert this back into an abattoir.
The legislators recommended relocating non-meat vendors to alternative sites. Recently, the National Environmental Management Authority, NEMA, halted operations to evict illegal settlers in wetlands, pending the formation of the Environment and Natural Resources Committee, which would oversee the management and restoration of wetlands. However, this week, NEMA began preparing to resume operations to evict wetland encroachers. This has raised fear among Kawala residents following eviction notices issued to them by NEMA. Today, the Kampala Lord Mayor, alongside the Rubaga North Member of Parliament, Abubakar Kawalia, had called for a meeting with Kawala residents to discuss a way forward. However, police blocked the planned meeting. Lukwago faulted NEMA for planning to resume the eviction of residents before formation of the National Environment and Natural Resources Committee.
Tekuli nti wali wakachiko, kale wachiso na bweru wachiso, wali badeo chiamani wayo, wakachiko nti yaze, na tambula nabu, taliwo.
Lebanon's Hezbollah chief said his group will not stop 11 months of fighting with Israel until the Gaza war ends, despite 2 days of deadly device explosions blamed on Israel. Nasrallah said that Israel had dealt an unprecedented blow to his group, crossing all red lines with device explosions. Nasrallah added that Israel will face tough retribution and just punishment where it expects it and where it does not. He further added that he would not give further details of the place, timing, and nature of Hezbollah's response. Nasrallah announced the launch of an internal probe into the explosion of hundreds of communication devices used by group operatives across Lebanon. The pager and walkie-talkie explosions on Tuesday and Wednesday killed 37 people and wounded nearly 3,000. Hezbollah blamed Israel for the unprecedented attacks, which dealt a huge blow to the powerful movement.